Greetings to all of you Internetians. This is Piano Bar Live, where we all connect with live music. The show starts now.
Well, look me over. I didn't dress like this for any old New Year's celebration. How is everyone tonight? Now I'm gonna play this next part of this boogie-woogie, which is a little strange, so I think it calls for a little explanation. See, it's what's known as a boogie-woogie break. Now when I get to this part in the music, I'm gonna stop playing. It's not because I forget the music. Oh, I never forget the music. It's just that there isn't any music written for that part. See, a break. Now, when we get to that break, I want you to all help me out and shout, hey. Do you think you can do it there at home? Shout, hey, like no one's watching. Or type it. See the comments. It's really nice to do it in the virtuality world of the face step and the chap snatch. Okay, here we go. Let's try it. We're going to shout, hey. Feels good, doesn't it? Well, let's do it again. You want to do it again, don't you? Oh, isn't this fun? What say all you kids under 25 try it this time? All right, let's hear that. Let's say. Bunch of liars. Well, this little boogie-woogie that I've been playing for you is the kind that is known as boogie-woogie, 8 beats to the bar. But now for a little invention of my own. Boogie-woogie, 16 to the bar.
Mr. Liberace.
Well, hello, Scott Barbarino. It's nice to see you.
Can I call you Lee?
Oh, I hope you will. You know, it's one of my nicer nicknames. I've got others, trust me.
I'm sure you do. So, Lee, welcome to Piano Bar Live, and it is our pre-New Year's show because we're trying to move closer to the ball dropping and getting to 2021 as quick as we can.
Oh, I'm ready to drop my ball. I can't wait. I'm so excited.
I'm thrilled to have you here with us. I want to tell you, since I was a little boy, I've loved you as a performer, and I know you as a performer since I was a little boy because I used to spend the evenings watching TV in the 60s with four of my aunts who all came together to watch that screen, and we would watch things like we would watch Liberace, or we would see Lawrence Welk, and yeah, I know. And And all of the programming in those days, and you were always a highlight. I have to tell you, all the old Italian ladies in Brooklyn, they loved you.
Oh, I know. They all sent me fan mail and love letters, and of course, they all thought they were going to marry me. That would have made us what relations, Scott? You would have been my great-grandnephew or something?
I don't know how that works. It would have been a pleasure to be related.
Oh, sure and is.
You're originally from the Milwaukee area in Wisconsin?
That's right. I was born in West Allis, Wisconsin, but I call it Milwaukee.
And Milwaukee is one of those towns. That's a working town in a blue state, I might add. So
I understand that now. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes,
oh, I'm
is.
101 years plus tax. I never thought I'd live to see the day again, you know?
There you go. So you're growing up with that. So what inspired you to... how did you start? You know, what was the motivation?
Well, you know, my father, though not the nicest man, he was one of the most wonderful, wonderful French horn players. And my mother, she played the piano. And so my brother George, you remember my brother George?
I was going to ask you about George. Yes, I do remember your brother George.
So George played the violin. And my sister Angie, she played the piano as well, you know. So it was a very, very musical family. And, you know, I tried the violin. It wasn't really for me, but there was a piano in the house. And I could just sit down when I was just a little wee tot. And I just started playing by ear. And, you know, it sort of just stuck with me. I really enjoyed it, and it stuck.
And it made a career for you.
It did. You know, I had a very, very overbearing mother, and, you know, she really needed me to make a career of it and make a lot of money so that I could install slot machines in her own room that she could play and always win, you know. There was a goal for both of us.
Nice. And so she would play the slot machines at home?
Oh, yeah. Oh, she would let me know when they ran out. Uh-huh. But she'd take a check if there was nothing left in it.
Put the money in them for her. Brilliant. So over your career, you played every venue, anytime you could, places like Carnegie Hall, right?
And oh, I did, yes.
What about Radio City Hall? Did you do Radio City?
I finally played Radio City Music Hall in 1985 and 6 and 7.
Yeah, and, I saw you there. I was in the audience with a bunch of my friends from the West Village.
Yes, you were the cutest guys in the house. There.
Thank you very much.
Yes, I remember. I thought you wanted to come up on stage, but it was better we kept a little distance, I think. Right.
Now, that wasn't a Christmas show, was it?
No, actually, I think you probably saw the Easter extravaganza where I came out of a Fabergé egg.
Yes, it was the Easter show. And yes, you came out of an egg.
Yes, we all sort of do, I think. But this one was really, really fancy. Yeah, it was good.
And at Radio City, well, let me ask you, though, have you ever had to share the stage with an animal, like a monkey or anything like that? Because we know that was part of, you know, you do whatever you had to in those days. And Elvis did it with a hound dog. How about you?
Oh, my goodness. Well, I've shared the stage with many, many wonderful people and some animals. I've done the Chinese acrobats of Taiwan. I had Elvis Presley was we passed each other on the stage in the Las Vegas and other animals. I had Barbara Streisand in my show. I've worked with a lot of animals. Yes.
And Peggy Lee.
Oh, my Peggy. You know, Peggy had a man who used to sit in her front row all the time who had a little orangutan who she used to bring to the show. It was Peggy always had the circus going with her, you know.
You got to love show business.
Oh, you know, it's a surprise a minute. You don't know what you're going to get.
Yep. And over the years, you know, costuming, my God, everything from so many feathers, so many rhinestones, diamonds, everything. Now, did you have insurance on everything with Lloyd's of London?
Oh, I had to, Scott. You know, I had to be very, very careful. But, you know, the scariest thing was that when it came income tax time, the tax collector tried to pin me for my write-offs of these costumes. I'd spend $300,000 a suit. And, you know, I had to go down to the tax office and prove that I don't wear these clothes, you know, to Safeway. So right. I wore my most extravagant costume and went to the tax office, and I barely fit in there. And I said, do you really think I wear this on the street? And finally, you know, he agreed with me. And I kept all my costumes in very, very secure warehouses, like Christmas gifts. Everything was in a warehouse, see?
And then you'd bring it as you needed it.
I did. I did indeed. You know, the people wanted it. So it's, you know, you got to give them what they want, you know.
Absolutely. And you were one of those, you're definitely one of those performers who gave the audience what they wanted. And that was flash and glitz and polish. And
how do you like the rings, Scott? Do you
like
the rings? Oh, good. Because let's face it, you bought them.
That's right. And they loved that. The audience loved supplying you with ticket sales.
Oh, you know, it was the audience was my, you know, the critics were very, very, very cruel. They would write some very hurtful things, you know, that kind of journalism that hits below the belt. And, you know, they would make me cry sometimes. And I would cry and cry. And I cried all the way to the bank.
There you go. So, Lee, we're going to get back onto the program with our other guests coming up.
Oh, good.
And we're going to have you back on a little bit later. And one of the things that we're going to do later on is we're actually going to throw some songs out there to the audience, and we're going to let them pick a request.
So that's wonderful.
That'll be fun. And
oh God, I can't wait to hear what it is.
No, I know. And you can, but you know, and I know that you can play anything.
Oh, we'll see. It's been a long time, Scott, so thank you. I've had very bad artistic representation, so it's nice that you brought me back to the inner tube. And
it is definitely an inner tube, and we're all floating on it.
Oh, gosh.
Of all of the songs that you've ever done, what is the most unusual, in your opinion, style of music that you brought to the stage? Song.
Well, you know, I tried to, you know, people, I love classical music, and it was something that people, I wanted people to enjoy it, you know, but it's long and it's boring. So I always add toward the popular music and would play classical music, but cut out the boring parts. So I was never, ever really tied to any one kind of music. Probably the most I can't even remember what would have been the most bizarre music, but I've played Mexican music with the Ballet Folklorico dancing with me, the Mexican hat dance. I don't think you can call it that anymore, can you?
I don't know, but you. But I know one thing. I heard you, as the decades changed in the 60s and the 70s and the 80s, Liberace kept up and kept current. You stayed right on it and made all of that stuff that was being musically created in those years your own.
Oh, I did. I played the overture from Tommy, and I did, you know, all the 60s boogaboo and all that good stuff. I really, really, really love doing all that. Anything to stay current and anything to make the people happy.
Yeah, a true star.
It's true.
A true
yeah.
superstar. So we'll see you a little bit later, Lee. Thank you.
Oh, I'm going to just slip out and get into something a little bit more spectacular
okay.
for you, Scott, okay?
I would expect nothing less.
I thank you for having me. Enjoy the show, everyone. There's wonderful people here tonight.
Hey, Tony, it's almost time for your corner.
Yeah.
And so, Liberace, baby.
Hey.
You know?
You got it's almost New Year's Eve. We had to bring the bling and the glitz, and I think that we have kicked it off in grand fashion. Thank you, Lee.
Yeah, I didn't even ask him about his candelabra.
There's always time.
Before I kicked it over to you, I wanted to ask everybody if you can share the stream underneath, as well as if you can help us with our Venmo and PayPal. That's greatly appreciated. And I have one last request today. That is that we are actually up for an award on Broadway World, and that is for producer of a virtual program. That's me, but I couldn't have done it without all of you watching and without everybody that's been on the show, and certainly not without Tony. So we're going to put a link up there on the side on the thread, and if you get a chance, and you have to, it takes a few minutes, but if you get the urge to support us by voting in that competition, please do so. It's a tight pack. We're running with some great shows in there. So
indeed,
All right, Tony, so it's all yours.
All right, then. Okay, I'll see you in a minute, Scott. Hey, everybody. So it's so great to have you with us. I am so excited that we are enjoying a pre-New Year's Eve because, as was indicated before, I don't know, I think there's a lot of this going around, but 2021 can't come quickly enough. So we got our duds on. We've got some glitz throughout the show. And of course, this is my time just to thank you, whether it's your first time or whether you've been following us from the beginning, whether you're watching us on YouTube or on Facebook or Broadway On Demand. Thank you so much for your support of this show. And as you can see down below, which I'll show you right now, Scott mentioned our virtual tip bowl. It is our virtual tip bowl that allows us to continue to bring the joy every Tuesday night and also provide a platform for these just these wonderful performers. I mean, tonight alone, I mean, we started off with, I mean, what more of an old favorite could you imagine than Liberace? But we've got some brand new folks that are new to our audiences tonight. So please help us continue to do this. Give what you can to our virtual tip bowl. You can give through PayPal or through Venmo. And we can't thank you enough. And oh yes, please continue the chat. It's like sitting at the bar, right? While all the performances are going on. So keep lighting up that chat. Give what you can. And most importantly, just enjoy the rest of the night and help us ring in what can only be a 2021 full of hope and excitement. And without any further ado, I'd like to bring back our illustrious producer, Scott Barbarino. Hey, Scott.
Thank you, Tony.
Thank you.
So, folks, 2020, so many things happened. We are still here, those of us that are fortunate, and we did lose a lot of people along the way, and that has to be heavy in everyone's hearts. One of the good things that's come out of this whole 2020 year is that we've been able to connect with a lot of people that we would never have been able to because of the internet and the programming that's come live for everybody all over the world. If you've got the internet, you can watch Piano Bar. And that was a dream of ours that we went with back in August of 2019, prior to the pandemic. But since then, so many good things have happened. And one of the good things that I've had happen this week is that I actually stumbled upon a group that are a piano. It's a piano-based business. It's out on the West Coast. And without further ado, I'm going to bring one of the pianists from that from that space that performs there, Mr. Brian Seat, and he's at the Alley in Oakland, California. Hi, Brian.
Hey, Scott. How's it going?
It's going well. And it's a thrill to be able, again, to be able to visit people all around with this, with the use of the internet. And I've watched several things that you've done and fell into the Alley in a big way. And especially seeing some of the comments from the guests that have been, you know, there and on Facebook, the comments about being sort of like a Cheers with the piano. So it sounds to me that it's the kind of place that I'm going to get to as soon as I can travel. And the Alley has been there for how long, Brian?
The Alley, it opened in, I think, in 1933. So it's been kind of a running establishment ever since then. And it's gone through a couple of owners. It's been a piano bar, I think, at least since the 50s, I think. We had this infamous piano player, Rod Dibble, who played there for 56, 57 years until he was 86, 87 years old and passed away, unfortunately, a couple of years ago. But yeah, it's been there for a while.
A good long run and still and still open, though not open for guests at the moment because of the situation with COVID. We have people in our New York community as well that played for, you know, a half a century. Marie Blake at the Five Oaks is one, for instance. And you came to New York a few years back, and one of the piano bars that you visited was, you went to Rose's Turn.
Rose's Turn, yeah. I would say it was probably one of my first piano bar experiences, and certainly in New York, and just got to stoke up that and I guess ever since kind of frequented piano bars. And at one point I stumbled into the, to the alley in 2016, and kind of made my way into playing there. So, yeah.
And we hope that that place is going to be open for a long time. And we're going to let everybody know shortly about how they can help you there and the challenges that you have. But can you bring on one of the other guests that we have who's also working at the alley when the place is open? You're also doing live streaming, so you actually are still giving your community music and a good feel. So,
right. Yeah, we've made it online as well. So that's been kind of, you know, as you said, an excellent way to keep the community together and kind of meet a lot of people that we normally wouldn't. So we're so thankful for you to have us on. But yeah, I do want to bring on Jeff Labus, who's the other piano player at the Alley. He's a pianist and composer and arranger. He is best known for working with Van Morrison and Bonnie Raitt, among others. But he's
small names.
Small names. Jeff, welcome. Unfortunately, Jeff can't see you guys, but he can hear you. So, Jeff.
Thanks for joining us, Jeff.
Good to see you all. I worked a number of rooms in New York way back, too, but they're probably closed by now.
Well, we'll go over that later.
Okay.
Jeff, you want to play now?
I'm ready.
Yes. Okay. Let's hear him. We need some music.
All right. This is an original. I think we've all been holding out for 2021 to come. So this is called I'm Holding Out.
Thank you, Jeff. And that song is perfect for the time, my friend. It's I had this whole discussion this week about holding out, because I just feel in New York City that once this is all over and people can get around again, that we're going to have a major resurgence here. More artists again than bankers and office workers, which is fine. They'll convert some of those office spaces into housing, I hope, because they're not coming back most likely. They're going to stay at home. What company would bring people back into an office space when they can get the same work out of them while they're sitting at home? Mm-hmm. Saves them that rental. So speaking of rental, the place that you're at, the Alley, we know that you're virtual and the space is going to open as soon as it's possible out there in California. But the virtual part of it, can you let our audience know how they can stop by and watch and visit with you to see what you folks are up to?
So we move virtually. We're mainly on Facebook. So our Facebook page, I think, is the Alley Piano Bar and at Facebook Alley
in Oakland.
Alley in Oakland, sorry. And then we've got all of our virtual live streams archived there. But every Friday night, Jeff and I kind of go on live to do a live stream. We take requests from our regulars. And then we also pair up with another piano bar across the bay called Martuni's. Fabulous piano bar as well. And so we've paired up with a couple of piano players there, and we do a live stream every second week on the Saturday. So
it's a thrilling thing to be able to spread that love.
It is.
Like I said, as soon as we can, we will be coming out to the West Coast. And that's on one of the it's on our list of places to absolutely stop in and see you guys there. You have an open mic type of a situation. Also, you have regular guests that come in, get up to the piano and sing. I'm sure sometimes you'll let somebody up there that you're not 100% sure of and they surprise you. And that's the feel of the old school piano bar. Jeff, you said that you went, when was it that you were working here in New York, Jeff?
I lived in New York in the 70s, from about 72 to 76. And I remember playing at places called, one of them was Six-ish, uptown the east side. One of them was Dr. Generosity, also on the east side.
An amazing time here in New York. And by the way, in the 70s, of course, everybody had written off New York as well at that point and said that it was never going to come back. So you were here during that heyday when it did. And music was one of the things that lifted it and brought it back. So thank you. We've got the stream, Facebook link up on the side for anybody that's interested in finding out about the Alley. And we have a lot of your fans and a lot of the customers from the Alley on the side saying hello to you. And I'm going to turn it over to you now, if I could, Brian, to bring on one of the guests who's a regular singer and performer there at the Alley, right?
Yes. Lori Robinson she's been going to the Alley since, I think, 2000. So she kind of grew up with Rod and kind of honed her chops, playing with him for years. And she's one, where is she?
Can't wait to hear her.
Yeah, so we'll do this little tune for you guys.
Folks, we're visiting with the Piano Bar family at the Alley in Oakland, California.
Oh, hold on. Wait. Sorry. I need to turn her on. Sorry.
The very thought of you and I forget to do. Those little ordinary things everyone ought to do. I'm living in a kind of daydream. I'm happy as a queen, and foolish though it may seem, to me, that's everything. The mere idea of you, the longing here for you. You'll never know how slow those moments go till I am near to you. I see your face in every flower, your eyes and stars above. It's just the thought of you, the very thought of you, my love. Thought of you, and I forget to do those little ordinary things everyone ought to do. And foolish, though it may seem to me, that's everything. The idea of you, the longing here for you. You'll never know how slow those moments go till I am near to you. I see your face in every flower, your eyes in stars. It's just the thought of you, the very thought of you, my love.
Beautiful.
Wonderful.
Yeah. Thank you, Laurie.
Thank you for having me. It's been a very delightful experience.
And you've been somebody that's been going, as Brian said, to the alley for over 20 years.
Yes, I was taken to the alley for a birthday party. And there was Rod behind the piano doing his thing. It blew my mind. It took me a few months to go back and actually get the gumption to sing. And Rod loved singers, and so he really encouraged me to learn more songs. The American Stand,
the songbook,
right? And that was his thing. And he really instilled in me the confidence and told me to reach for the stars, and you know, always try to do more, you know, because I was better than I thought I was. And it was addictive. You know, you get to the alley and you get that mic in your hand, and that was it. That was, it was a match made in heaven. And 20 years later, I'm still going to the alley virtually now, but I'm no better place.
You always bring the house down.
Oh, thank you, Jeff.
That is the beauty of Piano Bar and what we all do. That story is one that I've heard from many people here. It's creating that space that becomes a good place that for we become family and share it all through the through music.
And how lucky that he pulled you out of your shell. So you got to delight our audiences. Thank you.
Absolutely. So right now, the Alley is the last piano bar left in Oakland. Is that right?
That's correct.
And like everybody experiencing, the bills still come in the mail. The expectations for paying all of the rent and all of the other stuff that has to happen, taxes, et cetera, still in place. And you guys are surviving, but you've got some comp there. It's a considerable lift to make all of this works and to make all of this work. And you have a GoFundMe that you started to help support the owner of the Alley to take care and keep that place open and vibrant and there when I get to visit. So that's tell us a little bit about that GoFundMe, how it started, and what your expectations are. And Tony's going to put that on the screen as well. So anybody here in our audience that would like to help support this piano bar in any way, every little bit helps.
Yeah. So, so for the past, whatever, since March, I guess it's been closed, obviously. And Jackie Simpkins, the owner, she's been trying to make ends meet. She's pulled out all the loans and she's pretty maxed out. And we finally got word of that probably two, three weeks ago, perhaps. So the community kind of stepped up wanted to help out. So we started a GoFundMe on, I think, December 17th, which was 7 days, I guess, before Christmas Eve. And our first goal target was to make sure that she could pay the bills for the next 6 months. So we aimed to raise $75,000. And lo and behold, the community really stepped up. Word got out. Some famous actors from a movie that was shot at the Alley, Debbie Diggs, who's in Hamilton, he kind of tweeted, and then Rafael Casell as well tweeted out, got the word out. And amazingly, in 7 days, we reached that goal on Christmas Eve, which turned out to be like this amazing Christmas miracle. And so we were really thankful to the community. The Alley is, you know, almost, you know, over, I guess, 90 years old. But it requires some updates for health code reasons. So we're going to be launching a phase two. It's probably going to be $100,000 or so, but we're trying to get closer figures, but we're going to do an official launch. But the GoFundMe is currently still open. People are still donating, which is amazing and fantastic. And we're so grateful to everyone out there. So thanks to you too. Also thanks for raising awareness on this side of the coast. So
it's a wonderful thing that you're doing. And, I'm hoping that all the piano bars around the world are figuring out ways to stay open. And then once all of this is done, because the fact of the matter is that it's been music and the stuff that we bring, that's one of the things that's brought joy to people and a lot of energy and helped us survive during the last 10 months.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping to see piano bars opening so every community has some place where they can go and enjoy what it is that you clearly are enjoying at the Alley, what I know that we're enjoying here in New York at our piano bars. We want to spread that word. So folks, whatever you can do to support the Alley, again, there's their GoFundMe. And we really appreciate you guys stopping in to say hello. Jeff, anytime you want to come back to New York to say hello, and that goes for you as well, Brian and Lori, when we can move around, we hope you'll come this way as well. Okay.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Definitely.
Appreciate the chance to be with you.
Enjoy the rest of your afternoon or early evening, as we know that you are. We still see that sun out there. So whatever you've got planned, enjoy it and make sure you include music. I know you will.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Scott.
You're very welcome.
Thank you. It's great to meet you all. Thank you for sharing with us.
Thanks so much.
Bye now. Tony.
Yeah.
We got to do more of that. That's the way we can travel a little bit and show our audience what's going on out there in the big world.
Piano Bar is it's a big family. It's a big family. And there's like third and fourth cousins like all over the place that you didn't even know about. But you know, 21st century technology, all you have to do is look a little bit and you find people all over the place. And what a great It's a Wonderful Life type story that they had, you know? That movie's got nothing on them. That's great. That's exactly what I needed to hear right now.
Yep. And so we know that we're asking for money. And you're going to notice, by the way, that everybody's going to be asking for money because this is taking longer than we thought. Clearly, there's no complete guidance from above at this moment as to how we can get through to the other side. So please do consider to support whatever you can to keep all live music going, especially these small places, the piano bars. They're very challenged. Here in New York City, we have at the West Bank Cafe, Steve Olson and his group. There's a GoFundMe that's gone on there that Tom Dangora started with a few people that's exceeded their expectations because, of course, we want to keep the West Bank alive and well.
Yes.
Underneath the West Bank, of course, is the Laurie Beachman Theater. We have our friends there and so many great shows there. So, Tony, can you throw that GoFundMe up for the West Bank real quick, and then we'll move on to our next performer?
I threw it in the chat.
Excellent. So you people from everywhere, especially I know the New York Broadway crowd has been very supportive of that GoFundMe for the West Bank. That place has been it's like a special little place that God stuck a little pin in the earth and made it an amazing place. There's so many friends.
Very special. So great food, friends. Great atmosphere, and just the acts. Yeah. I mean, always a great show going on there. So it's a real landmark.
So right now I'm kind of on hiatus or furlough, as they call it, because our indoor dining stopped here in New York. And so Ellen Stardust Diner did close its doors. We were open at 25% from October 1st through December 13th. And now we've closed for the safety of all of our customers and our staff. One of the things that was happening in the diner when we were open is we were being safe, and all of the people that came in felt comfortable. Our staff felt comfortable, and I felt comfortable because I wanted to make sure everybody knew that we were following all the rules and the precautions. And one of the lucky things that happened for us is that were some schools that stayed open in New York City for performance and for the performing arts. And one of them is AMDA, American Musical Drama. I've got it wrong already. American Musical. Tony, help me.
You want to know something? I think that's a really great idea. When we chat with our friend, we won't guess. We'll get it straight from our guest.
Yep. So anyway, listen, some of those kids came into Ellen's and helped us out with being a part of our audience and helping us out. It's the American Musical Dramatic Arts School. And the next guest that's coming up is one of those students that came in that we really enjoyed meeting her. She's got a great voice, a great personality, also a great story. And she's going to do a number from a show that was just getting its feet, just getting really up and running, got all kinds of good reviews and word of mouth. And that was Six. And that closed in March. But here's a little number. And we're going to bring on right now Viviana Renteria. And she's going to do a number for you from Six.
All you wanna do, baby. I think we can all agree I'm a 10 among these three. All you wanna do, baby. And ever since I was a child, I make the boys go wild. All you wanna do, baby. Take my first music teacher, Henry Mannix. I was young, it's true, but even then I knew the only thing you wanna do is tall, dark, Sexy Manux taught me all about dynamics. She was 23 and I was 13, going on 30. We spent the hours strumming the lute, striking the chords and blowing the flute. He plucked on the strings all the way to G, went from major to minor, C to D. You say what you need, what you want, you don't need to plead, cause I feel like a mystery, like I got you and you got me, and maybe this is it, he just got so much, this feels legit, we have a connection, I think this guy is different, yes! Touch me, love me, can't get enough, see. It's please me, squeeze me, birds and the bees me. Run the fingers through my hair, tell me I'm the fairest of the bird. Playtime's over, the only thing you wanna do is. But then, there was this other guy, Francis Durham. Serious, standing slow, that's what he wants, but he won't take no passion. You know that he touches from the secretary to the tower of the chase, filling his office had a duty to fulfill. He even let me use his favorite quill, spilled ink all over the parchment, my wrist was so tired, but I still can the next day as he required. You say I'm all you need, all you want, you don't need to plead, cause I feel like chemistry, like I got you and you got me, and I know this is it, he just got so much, this one's legit, we have a real connection, I think this time is different, yes! Touch me, love me, can't get enough, see. Squeeze me, squeeze me, birds and the bees me. You can wait a second more to get my corset on the floor. Playtime's over, the only thing you wanna do is. Yeah, that didn't work out. So I decided to have a break from boys, so you never guess who I met. Tall, large, Henry VIII, Supreme Head of the Church of England. Globally revealed, although you wanna know from the look of God. Maybe a lady waiting her, me and my family up in the world. Gave me this in court and he swears it's true, that without me he doesn't know what he do. You say I'm all you need, all you want, we both agree. Sunday's the place for me, I'm finally where I'm meant to be. Then he starts saying all this stuff, he cares so much, he calls me in love. He says we have this connection, I guess it's not too deep. Cause touch me, love me, can't get enough, see. Excuse me, squeeze me, birds and the bees me. Then a place for when or now, cause you just got to have me now. Playtime's over, only thing you wanna do is. So we got married. Woo! With Henry, it isn't easy. His temper short and his mates are sleazy. Except for this one courtier. He's a really nice guy, just so sincere. The royal life is the one I planned. Both of us in virtual and a helping hand. So sweet, make sure that I'm okay. And we hung out loads when the away. These guys finally is what I want, the friend I need. Just friends, no chemistry. I'm finally where I'm meant to be, and there's nothing more to it. He just cares so much, he's the old friend. He says we have this connection. I thought this time was different. What did I think he'd be different? He's never, ever different. Cause it starts me when will enough be enough, see? It feeds me, don't care if you don't feed me. Believe and pull my hair, tell me I'm the fairest of the fair. Playtime's over. Playtime's over. Playtime's over. The only thing you want to do is...
Thank you, Viviana. Don't forget to do that quick toggle.
Yes, ready.
Thank you. That was beautifully executed. It really was wonderful.
Thank you very much.
You've got a lot of people on the thread that are really appreciating what you just did.
Thank you very much.
Soon six will be open again, I'm thinking. I'm pretty sure that that's coming back. And soon... You're on break right now from AMDA, right?
Yes, I am.
And you are originally from Colombia?
Yes, from Colombia, Bogota, Colombia.
And you decided that you wanted to be a musical artist and perform in musicals here and got into AMDA. And when did you actually start your program there?
I started November. I was supposed to start in June, but due to the COVID and the pandemic, everything got moved and I started in November.
Right. Wonderful. And you've been taking classes there and virtually, right?
Yes. Yes. Right now we are in a hybrid program where we have some classes in person and other in Zoom through online.
Viviana, you are the hope of the future that we look at and say, we have another batch of young people that we used to call those newbies in the day that will take the mantle and bring the music to everybody as you have. And one of the things that I love about what you want to do is that you actually want to incorporate your family and the people back in Colombia and bring that music and love to them as well. And I think that tonight we have.
Yes. I would love to be able to open the doors of this amazing industry back in my country and be one of the persons that, you know, open the doors to new artists, new dreams, and, you know, like this whole industry. I would like to take it back to my country.
I have a feeling that you're going to be able to do that. You have the whole package there.
So thank you
so much for joining us here at Piano Bar Live tonight. And I hope that when we open up Ellen Stardust again, that we'll see you and your friends come on back in to visit with us. And we're also looking to bring some of the other students there onto future streams so that we can show everybody the good work that's happening. One of the teachers there is actually... I don't know if you know Brandy Massey, but she's one of our performers at Ellen Stardust. And right now she's actually teaching at AMDA as well. So look her up if you haven't taken any class with her and just say hello.
Yes, unfortunately, I do know her. Unfortunately, I haven't been able to have class with her. But I mean, as soon as I can, I will say hello. Thank you very much.
She's the real deal. All right. So Viviana, enjoy the new year ahead. And thank you. And thank you to all of your friends that came in to visit with us today, where we connect with live music here at Piano Bar Live.
Yes, thank you very much for the opportunity and Happy New Year's. Thank you.
Happy New Year. Our next guests, we're running a little bit behind. I apologize. You know, that's me. Our next guests they've been on the show before. They are a dynamic duo working out of one space quarantined together. We've had them on the show before. They did an amazing piece from Sweeney Todd, Have a Little Priest, in one of the previous shows. And tonight they've put something together for us. So we're going to now welcome Kat and RJ.
Ready to end this year.
Yeah, me too.
Salute. It's a quarter to three. There's no one in the place except you and me. And Caddy.
So set 'em up, Joe. I got a little story that you ought to know.
We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road.
I got the routine. So put a little nickel in that there machine. Our refrigerator runs.
I'm feeling so bad. Can't you make the music dreamy and sad? I could tell you a lot, but I gotta be true to my code.
So make it one for my baby
and one more for the road.
Yeah.
You'd never know it, but buddy, I'm a kind of poet. And I got a lot of things to say.
And when I'm gloomy, thanks for listening to me till it's all talked away.
Always. That's how it goes. And Joe, I know you're getting real anxious to close.
Let's get out of this year.
Close out this year.
So thanks for the year. I hope you don't mind that we just stayed here
all year.
But this torch that we found, it must be drowned, or it soon might explode.
So make it one for my baby and one more for the road.
That long.
It's so long. So long, 2020.
I'll drink to that.
Hey, RJ and Kat.
Hey.
Thank you so much for coming back on to Piano Bar Live. Kat, I know you from Ellen Stardust. RJ, I know you through Kat. You guys have been making great music together.
Thank you.
It's our pleasure.
I hope you have some projects. I know the two of you are great thinkers and you're working on stuff to keep yourselves busy over the next couple of months.
Yep.
Yeah, apart from painting every inch of our apartment that you see behind us, when we're not painting every inch of our apartment, we are kind of creating art for other people. We're doing commissions. We're also working on other little projects, doing things like this. And
RJ just found a writing partner, which is exciting. So we'll see where that goes.
Here's to 2021, you guys.
Exactly. Cheers. We adapted and
and started doing voiceover work.
Yes,
that's the main thing that we did.
And excellent. I got my first gig.
You got to stay alive. You got to figure out how to keep it going.
Absolutely.
Wake up every day and find out what the sweet spot is.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Thank you stay for bringing happy. It to us tonight. So we're going to head out now and wish you both again a happy new year.
Happy new year.
Keep me abreast of what's going on, anything that you need us to promote for you, okay?
And happy birthday, Mom.
Oh, happy birthday, Mom.
My birthday was yesterday. It's a rare
happy
occurrence.
Happy birthday, RJ. I did see that Thank pop you. Up. I think I said happy birthday. I'm Indeed, not so good at that. Sometimes I fall behind. So anyway, yeah, guys, thank you so much. And we'll see you soon.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Cheers. Tony, we are ready to bring back the amazing Liberace.
Oh, hi. Yeah, Viviana, of course you can borrow the cape. Oh, you're wonderful. Oh, hi, Scott. Hi, how are you?
Hi, Lee. I'm hoping that, yeah, we just brought you all over the place with us to see.
I'm happy to be anywhere these days.
Yeah, I'm sure. So you got a number for us, but after, I think maybe this would be a good time to give people an opportunity. After you do this number, we're going to actually we're going to set up a request for three different songs.
Oh, isn't that exciting?
It is. And Tony is going to put them up. Tony, would you put up A so you can hear Mac the Knife? B, Chopsticks, which is a favorite of mine. And As Time Goes By. So on the side thread, whatever you'd like to hear Lee play for you in the next number, just put it up there on the side on the thread and we'll take a look and we'll toss that over to him as soon as he's done with this number that's coming up. Thank you so much.
Oh, wonderful. I can't wait to hear what it's going to actually be. Now, what do you think of this outfit, Scott?
It's unbelievable.
Do you like it, Scott? Do you like my white fuzzy balls?
The white fuzzy balls make it. And is white is one of your, like, obviously white and black are your favorite colors. But
sure.
You know how to, that's the New Year's stuff. But you know
well,
how to
this is an exciting
well.
New Year's party tonight, Scott.
Mm-hmm. We're going at it early here, Lee.
Oh, I love it. I love it. I went out early and we should get 2020 at the hella here early, huh?
We definitely need to. So we're going to go off, let you do your thing, and then we're going to come back on and we'll have whatever that is that the folks are requesting.
Oh, I can't wait. Thank you, Scott. Thank
You're
you.
Welcome.
Oh, wait here. Oh, Viviana, here you go. Here you go. Yeah, I got three of them in all different sizes. I like to eat, so I come in thin, fat, and impossible. Well, I hope you're having a wonderful time with all this amazing talent in the virtual piano world on Piano Bar Live. I'm thrilled to be here. Here's to you all for a better 2021. This is a cup of tea. That's what I'm having now. And I'll probably have a different one later, but for now, it's going to be tea. And I hope you'll join me in a cup of tea for two. Not actually in it. We'll have it, okay? Here we go. Tea for two. I can't wait to hear it myself. Thank you.
Mr. Liberace Lee, they don't make them like you anymore.
Oh, thank God, huh?
You're harking back to a day when you were called Mr. Show Business, is that right?
I was Mr. Showmanship.
Showmanship.
Yes.
And you still have it, and you have that lovely, the candelabra behind you is also quite special. And you used to have one of those on the piano or nearby at all times.
Always, always. I got that idea from a movie about Chopin. See, he didn't have the song to remember. And in one scene, he didn't have enough light to play. So a cute little maid sort of hopped over and put one on his piano, and it seemed to inspire him. So I thought I'd try it too. And it became
folks,
my trademark.
If you want to have a joy, go on YouTube and look also at, you know, look at Liberace's all over there. There's one particular one that I enjoy. Is when you played with Mr. Jimmy Durante.
Oh.
Yeah. You played the piano. He broke his. So it's all there. And you deliver it. You're still delivering it brilliantly. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. I'm glad I still got it, you know.
Yeah. Watching on the thread, I see that the selection that everybody is requesting is As Time Goes By.
Oh, good, good, good. Well, it's a lovely little tune, and I hope I remember it. So let's give it a whirl.
I'm sure you will.
I got to tell you, it wasn't the one I thought was going to get picked. But
no?
It's a lovely song, so let's do it, okay?
I like Chopsticks myself, but...
Yeah. Next time, Scott, if you'll have me back, we'll
yes,
play Chopsticks
absolutely.
And all that stuff.
And we okay? have it. We do run like a democracy here, of course. So,
I love that. Thank God for that, ladies and gentlemen.
We
so now
democracy.
A little As Time Goes By.
As Time Goes By.
Still tea.
Lee, of all the gin joints in the world, thank you for stopping in and visiting us tonight.
I couldn't be more honored, Scott, to be here with you tonight and all the wonderful talent that have joined you for this wonderful evening.
Thank you. We're going to have David Maiocco will be back on in a few minutes. We're going to talk to him a bit, too. All right.
So, I can't wait. Bye, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Be good to one another. I love you.
Thank you. Have a wonderful new year ahead, Lee.
Thank you, Scott. I love you.
Keep those feathers. Keep all of that rhinestone going, my friend. So, ladies and gentlemen, we at Piano Bar Live, again, appreciate you being here with us. We try to bring you a little mix of all kinds of things to show you what's out there and available. And now, if we could, we're going to bring on our mystery guest. He's been on Piano Bar Live before. He's got a lot of things to say about a lot of things, and he's a dear friend. So, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Warren Schein.
Whoa, it's... When did you grow up?
Hey, Warren.
How are you, Mr. Barbarinowitz?
I'm hanging in there.
I know. So is Liberace's balls, but...
They were nice, weren't they? They were nice and fuzzy.
I want to know... Nice and fuzzy. Right away, you go for the low jokes.
No.
How does he fit the three of them in those pants?
There you go.
He really is something. That David Maiocco is... That is Liberace.
Yes, it is. And you are Warren Schein.
I try. Let me just say l'chaim to everyone as I finish my Metamucil.
That is not Metamucil, is it? It's the right color.
That's Metamucil. You know, it's the elixir of life. Let me just put it.
Sure is.
Oh,
it sure is. You know, Chris. What is it? Satchmo used to swear by fiber.
Oh, yes, it's the great... I'm telling you, you can't
Swiss
live
Chris. Us. I think he used Swiss Chris. He was old school.
I never heard of Swiss Chris.
Oh, yeah, that's a special. You can still get that if you look at the right spot in the drugstore. You got to go. It's all the way in the back.
You know, remind me of my grandmother when she used to put saccharin, those little tablets, into her coffee.
Are you sure it was saccharin?
No, it was either that or cocaine. I don't know what it was.
Well, you know, Warren, in those days, you know, we think of our... We think of mom and grandma, and we think of them the way they are, and we sometimes forget. I actually saw somebody the other day, this young guy, and he was dancing to something from the 70s.
Really?
And I said to him, wow, I said, you got some good taste in music. I said, he looked at me and he said, well, you dance? I said, well, I did then. Anybody that you see that's old now, more than likely was dancing at some time when they were younger. Because it's part of life, right?
Well, that's just, we are, we come from whom we, from when. That's from all when. I can, no, it's true.
Because but you have show business in your blood.
Yes, I do. My mother was a lyric soprano and a tap dancer. And one time she was on the radio with Eddie Cantor and Fanny Brice. And she could really sing. You know, in fact, I just got a call from an agent of mine hoping that this virus, this COVID, will be over in the next year or so because they're doing some auditions, you know, for future shows. Right. And there's going to be a new Mel Brooks comedy that was supposed to come out, but of course it was postponed. And after three callbacks, I've got the lead in a new Brooks comedy. It's called The Prostate Monologues.
Well, there you go. Yeah. You know, you had me there for a minute.
I know I did. And there'll be three intermissions. So,
you know, my grandmother was also in show business, Warren.
Really?
She was a dancer in the Hoboken Follies back in the 30s. Yes, indeed. She was the shortest girl on the line. And in those days, they called that was the pony girl.
Yes.
And then they would have her do little, because she was the shortest one in the line, there was that comedy element and they would add stuff in. And one of the big numbers in the Hoboken Follies in those days was a great tune. But if I could remember it, I'd let you know. But I'm not having Metamucil, but I should also be taking the Ginkgo Bilobas or something. Prevagen, right?
Prevagen. Yeah, I like those commercials. I'm 67 years old. I was an advertising executive for 45 years, and my memory was going. So now I'm taking Prevagen, and I mix it with Viagra.
And what happens?
It's, well, I'll tell you the truth. You know, my father, God bless him, had fallen and he broke his hip. So he was in rehab after the hip surgery. And I said, Pop, how do you like it here? I was visiting him. He goes, I love it. Every night just before I go to sleep, they give me a delicious cup of coffee. You know, it's just delicious. It's, I love it. I love it. And Viagra. That's a funny combination, you know. So I said to the nurse as I was leaving, what's with this combination of this special? Well, first of all, she said, it's not coffee. It's hot chocolate. It helps to calm and soothe his nerves so he'll sleep. The Viagra stops him from rolling off the bed.
And there you go.
That's it. I'm telling you. You know, comedy's very hard virtually. Well, I couldn't say it like that. It's difficult. You know, it's very difficult.
We won't have to worry about you rolling out of your bed at least tonight.
No, that won't happen.
So, no. Warren, no. one of the great things that you've been doing is you've been doing virtual shows and you've been bringing song and comedy into the nursing homes in New York City and on Long Island and Jersey too. You cover the tri-state, right?
Yes.
So you do that. In some cases, you were actually doing that in the venues at a certain point during COVID, correct?
Oh, yes. You know, I was doing quite a few. I just finished. I was working with Lydia Sebasto. We have bookings coming up. We were doing the JCCs of New York and Long Island. And we're doing Landmark on Main Street on January 13th. And we have some other dates that are booked. It's the new reality. You know, you can sit home and cry, or you can be on Piano Bar Live and have a great
place.
What you and Tony are doing are just amazing. And there are others, but you know what? You can't sit home and complain.
No, you can't. And by the way, it was Minnie the Moocher.
That's right.
Because my Prevagen or whatever just kicked in. That was the big number.
It was Minnie the Moocher.
Minnie the Moocher.
It was. But we've got to keep busy. It's just, you know what? I've never had so much time on my hands in my life, you know, and working on projects and writing material.
I can't wait to get you back on a live stage, Warren. I have plans to do that as soon as we can.
Yes, we do. We do.
And one of the highlights of my career in being able to book shows and bring people on was the night that I had you. And you came onto the Iridium stage with a good friend of yours, who we all miss, Dana Lorge.
And, greatest night. One of the greatest nights of our lives was that night.
I think that Dana would be, if she's up there watching, would probably be saying, I want one of those outfits that Lee is wearing.
You know, it's true. I was thinking about that, and it's interesting that you bring it up, because that evening at the Iridium, and for those people that were there, it was without a doubt the funniest night of cabaret. Dana was wearing a silver lamé gown. It looked like a curtain for a window. And when she introduced me to come on, she was waving her arms in the air, and I just introduced her, and I said, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Chrysler Building.
And that laugh went on for a while.
It did. It was a great night. You produced a wonderful show that night.
Had a good, lot of good stuff happening. So, Warren, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure. And thank you.
Yeah, keep me in the loop of what's going on.
I certainly will.
We're going to go back now and close out the show.
Great talent tonight. God bless you. And
thank
Tony.
You, Warren. Okay, Tony. It's time to bring on David Maiocco.
Hey.
Hey, David.
How about that? How about that for a quick change?
That was pretty good, actually.
It looks I got out of the Chrysler Building.
You got kind of like that Elvis thing going on now.
Yeah, see, these are reels, so that makes it easy. It cuts out about like 10 minutes of spirit gum and all that junk that people have to do.
So what an amazing performance earlier in the show your friend Lee put on.
Thank you. He's okay.
It brings you, it's like anybody that... Now, again, I was fortunate enough to actually see him in live performance. People that haven't, again, there's that YouTube stuff that you can look, or you can actually see David. Now, David does several different shows. I'm going to ask you, can you just let the audience know how they can see you?
Sure. Yeah. I, you know, like Piano Bar Live, we've had to embrace the pandemic. We've had to do what we have. And I think a lot of people have enjoyed having this talent brought to their living rooms. It's really great. And like Scott said before, he was the first one doing it pre-pandemic. I tuned into your very first shows with Michael Macasey, and I think it's a wonderful thing, and I hope it doesn't go away. Actually, it doesn't need to go away just because we get to go back. I pray that we are going to go back very soon. But I've been very fortunate to hook up with some friends from Provincetown who do. I want to call it the sister network, the virtual piano bar, with John Richardson and Jonathan Hawkins and Heather Lundstedt Price, who's another one of our producers. And we have great performers. And we have a lot of crossovers too, like Bob Egan and Michael Macasey, who appear on Piano Bar Live and Virtual Piano Bar. So I do shows as me, as David, and I do shows as Liberace coming up, going on through the year as planned right now. Once a month, I'll be Liberace, and three times a month, I'll be David. And hopefully having wonderful guest stars like you saw tonight on the show each week.
And the night of the week?
Is Sunday nights at 6:30. And that is on Virtual Piano Bar and also on my Facebook page. You can look me up. 6:30s on Sundays. I'm right before Bob Egan at 8.
There's a lot of great programming on that channel. They're doing a really good job of creating a platform that can just generally bring the word out to all kinds of people that wouldn't see you otherwise. And that's the beauty of this, because we will continue to do this afterwards, because let's face it, in the average piano bar, even in a concert hall, you know, you can fit anywhere between 75 to 1,000. And we still get to reach hundreds of thousands of people out there. Hopefully, as they learn about Piano Bar and they realize exactly what joy it brings.
Yeah.
And
I'm so glad I got to experience it in New York City. I lived in New York from 99 until 2005 and got to meet you and a lot of wonderful people while in the city. And I'm so glad that you are authentically bringing it. Trust me, this is authentic, what Scott's bringing to your living room.
And this
it's really a wonderful lineup. And nobody does it better than you, Scott.
Appreciate that. I see a lot of other good stuff out there, and we always want to support everybody. You know what? We have 24 hours in the day, 7 days a week, and somebody somewhere is watching something. So we've got plenty of time to fill, and we're doing it really well. And I appreciate the stuff that you're bringing, to this virtual world. It's magnificent.
Thank you. I'm happy to do it, and I'm grateful to be able to do it. So,
and as soon as I can get you in front of a live audience again of any size, you and I will figure that out. We want to keep that what you're doing out there and get it back into the mainstream. And a couple of months, we'll see. Play it by ear.
Yeah. Thank you, Scott.
But we have gotten through 2020. And
everybody, tea, wine, whatever you're drinking.
I don't know what you're drinking, but it looks good. What do you have? A little wine?
It's a little Chardonnay now. This was Lee's throat coat. I know it looks the same color, but this really was tea.
Okay.
This one isn't.
As long as it wasn't Metamucil, that's what we're doing good.
No, we already did that this morning. See?
There you go. So listen, thank you so much for joining us here tonight. And I will see you on the Virtual Piano Bar on Sundays.
Wonderful. Thank you. Happy New Year, my friend.
Thank you. Wonderful to see you, and Happy New Year.
To everybody. Thank you.
Tony, come on and let's say goodnight to everybody.
Well, yes, I say goodnight, and it's been a lot of fun poking 2020 really hard with our elbows in the ribs, but I would be remiss if I just didn't take a moment to say this has been a consistent bright spot, certainly for me, and I hope for everyone who has been joining us. I guess that's why you keep coming back. But thank you, the people, the tippers, the supporters, the chatters, all of you. You've made this. You've been a lifeline this year.
Thank you, everybody. And yes, again, one more time, we can always use a little bit of help. with Venmo and PayPal. There are expenses to doing these.
Yes.
And I'm not whining, but I am back on furlough. So it's like, let's see what we can do. So everybody support each other. We mentioned a couple of different things that you can do tonight. And the least you can do is to spread the word. So if you share our link for tonight, so if you enjoyed tonight's show, share the link. And if you didn't enjoy tonight's show, what's wrong with you?
Yeah.
It was a great, night. Get out of here. What a great night. Thank you, everybody. We don't have an announcement for next week because we're waiting to make all announcements after New Year's Eve. We'll make announcements about the upcoming shows.
Indeed. So thanks for joining us, and we'll see you. Wait a second. I have a special banner just for this somewhere. See you in 2021.
Ah, look at that.
Aren't you glad I made you wait for that?
10.
Anyway.
9. 8. 7. Everybody, have a great new year.
Happy New Year. Peace.